This video is sponsored by LD Player. However, this is not a video that is sponsored by Konosuba. And so why I want to make that distinction is because I want to give you guys assurance that I will give you like an honest review about this game. But look at her. She's so cute. Don't you guys already like want to install the game? Hi, welcome back to my channel. My name is Lace. And today we're going to be talking about Konofan, or also known as Konosuba Fantastic Days. There's a lot to talk about in this game. Like, you know, is it good? It's run by Nexon. What do you think about that? I think the first point that I do want to address is the whole Nexon thing. And I think, like, generally speaking, the community is pretty fine with the way that it's going. I completely understand that these publishers are not exactly the most well-liked in like the gacha community. However, I would say that this game is definitely worth trying. And so with that out of the way, I want to talk about what I'm going to be talking about today. And so it's kind of like my first impressions, comparisons to especially like pre-con, because a lot of people are like, oh, it looks like a pre-con knockoff. Looking at the end game loop, stuff like that, like I've actually played through to like day two, and like I haven't finished the game, but like it feels like I can see the end game loop. It looks like there's a lot going on, but there really isn't that much going on. And I would say if you guys are like already Konosuba fans, I would definitely recommend that you pick this guy up. However, before going on further, as much as I actually like this game, I don't know if I'm going to be able to pick it up full time. And the reason is because I'm juggling freaking 5 gacha games right now. And so the only reason I'm not going to pick this up is because I just do not have the time. Look, even she's sad for me, man. Anyway, like without further ado, let's jump into the video. And the first thing I want to talk about actually is rerolling itself. Rerolling in this game is actually a dream, so I'm not gonna do anything here, but like essentially it's about like a 3 to 4 minute process before you actually get up to the point where you can roll for your characters. And so let me hit the gifts real quick, go into the gift log. And so as you can see here, there are a lot of gifts. So we've got a 4-star guaranteed ticket. 4-star is your highest rarity. It's the equivalent of the SSR in this game. You got the 1200 quartz, you got more 300 300, I'm gonna come up a bit, 3300. We're gonna get another like 2900 somewhere. All in all, from what I can tell, Nexon has been very, very generous in terms of like these gifts and like these pre-registration rewards. There are so many other gachas that I've tried recently, especially that have been like real stingy about like the pre-registrations or like the launch rewards. This game is not one of them. They actually are like bombarding us. And from what I hear, like we're probably going to be getting like another 10 pool tomorrow, or like another 4-star select, oh, not a select, a 4-star ticket or something. And to be honest, like that's pretty freaking lit. So like we're off to a great start. I think generally speaking, the launch has been quite good. It's quite successful. However, that's not really what makes like the reroll really great. What I really want to talk about is this button right here. So yeah, it's a button that actually makes it really good. So in the menu, in the profile over here, what you're going to see here is a remove account button. And so like why this is so good is because like if you finally get up to the rolls, do your rolls, and it turns out to be like dog water, then what you can do is you can actually just come over to profile and hit that remove account button and your account gets nuked. So what this means is that you don't have to actually do any funky stuff like with like rooting or like, you know, cloning instances and stuff like that. You can just click this button and go all the way to the very start and start again. Like it's so actually so easy. And so yeah, with this reroll system, especially with the rates and stuff, I'll talk about that like right after this. I think the whole reroll process, it's like a very solid 9 out of 10. 3 to 4 minute reroll, a button to actually like reset your entire account. Like it's obvious that they're embracing the Risimara or like the rerolling culture. And so yeah, like for me, 9 out of 10. And the only thing that could probably make it better is like if there was a selector at the start. However, with the introduction of a selector, we already know like the goalpost just keeps moving. It's like, okay, well, you got to get this and these characters or whatever, but that's another like conversation for another day. But yeah, in terms of like reroll friendliness, like 9 out of 10, and I'm very happy that they're actually doing this. All right. And so speaking about the rates, let me hop over to the gacha menu. So we've got a whole bunch of banners here. And so as you can see, we have the summer banner. So we've got like a swimsuit Melissa and a swimsuit. There's another one, but I don't know actually how to get to it. Oh, there she is. Okay. And so like we have these two summer units, and then we also got the release celebration. So you can see the iconic Megumin. And so Megumin and Kazuma are on rate up. However, what is probably of most interest to us is the bad boys that are like the percentages, the statistics, the rates, you know, what rates are we going to be getting them at? So first of all, you will be pleased to hear that there is a 250 pity, and this is already 50 better than pre-con. However, what is even better than this is this bad boy over here. Wait a second, it's not in here. All right, I finally found it. And so like what I want to show you guys is this bad boy over here. 4% rate for a 4-star, aka SSRs, aka the highest rarity units in the game at 4-star rate. Like that is so lit. Not only does this help rerolling, but it also like hopefully rounds out your chances as you progress through the game. But to be honest, like these rates are exceptionally high. Like I haven't seen rates like this for quite a long time. However, rates don't always tell the whole story. And so like there are duplicate systems in the game in which you need like dupes to actually upgrade their skills. But I think there are actually also like generalist items that you can use to upgrade them as well. But like just on that, like the rates are really freaking sick. But yeah, all in all, oh my gosh. Oh, look at those melons. That cabbage. Look at that cabbage. Yeah, let's move on. Let's go home. And I'm gonna show you, actually, let me show you some gameplay because like I want to address the comment of like, oh, it's a pre-con knockoff or it's a pre-con clone. And so looking at the quest menu, yeah, it kind of does look like it, doesn't it? So we've got the main quest, we've got the free quest over here, which essentially is your grotto or like your resource stages. We got a battle arena, which is essentially your end game. Like you're gonna be going through and like essentially killing a boss with infinite HP. Essentially, you go through like three rounds, and on round three, you fight this guy and he has infinite HP and you're just trying to deal as much damage as you can. However, let me show you some gameplay itself. So let's hop back to quests. Let me go farm something. So let me go into main quest. Let me go to hard and let's see if I can do this. Oh, that one looks a bit hard. I'm gonna give it a shot because like, yeah. But yeah, this is very, very reminiscent of pre-con. I 100% can see why people call it the clone. We've got the skip tickets down here. Music to my eyes. Like, oh my God, I love skip tickets. Like they should exist in every freaking game. However, let's just get into the stage itself. And so as you can see here, this is how your party is formed. So you got three in the front line and then two in the rear guard. However, what's really interesting about this is that your front line is deployed first and your rear guard are kind of like your reserves. And the only way that your rear guards actually see some gameplay is if one of your front units actually die. And so for example, I went in and like Leah died. And so like this chick would actually like come in and take her spot. I'm still not 100% sure as to like why that mechanic is there. Like I personally thought that it'd be like three in the front and then two in the back. That's kind of what it implies, like front and rear guard, but such is life. And it's like, it's okay. So you got like three units on the field. So let me just show you some gameplay real quick. So I'm gonna hit begin and I'm gonna turn off auto and stuff. So you guys can actually see, we get a little bit more choice. Well, we actually get a lot more choice than pre-con. So let me hit the auto off. And so as you can see, we can actually choose which actions we want to do. This is, yeah, this is music to my ears. Oh God, wait, am I dying? Oh my God, okay, maybe we can actually see the rear guard mechanic very soon, which is really sad because it means I'm losing. Okay, so as you can see, like we've got the three characters, we're versing like these enemies on this side. And then so we've got this active time battle. I think that's what they call it, like the active time battle bar. I'm gonna just hit auto because like I've shown you guys the manualing and it is what it is. Oh my God, my character's about to die. Anyway, so we have this this bar, and essentially when it reaches full, we will be able to do an action. And on the other hand, we've got the blue bar, which actually indicates like your ultimate move or your super move. And so what you can, oh, look at my heal. Anyway, so that's the super move right there, as you saw, and this one right here as well. And so essentially, like you just need the full blue bar to be able to do it. And then we've got buffs on top of them. We've got elemental weaknesses. Yeah, elemental weaknesses, like for me personally, oh my God, I am getting absolutely slammed. Okay, well, I'm just gonna pause the video right here and completely win this game. Okay, guys, that was really awkward because I tried to forfeit, but it actually didn't let me forfeit. And then it actually like went on to win. Although I only got two crowns. That was really freaking awkward. Anyway, so what we have here is the affinity. Affinity is like how attached or like your relationship with that character. And then up here, we've got the classic three stars or three crowns in this game. And so you can see what the requirements are right here. But yeah, that's essentially the battle system in a nutshell. Like I like that there is a lot more control over it. Like you can actually, there's a lot more like creativity that you can do. If you can't auto a stage, you can actually take it into your own hands to potentially do it better. But like generally speaking, I just slammed that auto button. And so yeah, the drops are like very reminiscent of pre-con. Like it is, it kind of is like a pre-con clone maybe. But what I do want to say about all of that is like, as you guys saw, it's actually like the models are actually quite different. It's like they're chibi, but they're not like pre-con chibis, right? So if I click into one of these, can I actually see the model? Okay, well, I actually can't see the model, but like essentially they kind of like pretty much look like these guys over here, right? They're kind of like not full chibis. They're like semi chibis. And I actually really like this art style. And on top of that, we also have like an insane amount of live 2D. Like, look at that. It's, wait a second. Wait, I could even argue that's like kind of 3D. But yeah, the production value in this game is pretty insane. Like, it runs buttery smooth. Like, look at all that. Like, going through the menus, like, this is not something I would ever say about Alchemy Stars. It's constantly running at 60 FPS. Like, all the menus feel really good to go through. Like, the combat feels really good to play if you decide to engage. So guys, before we keep going with the video, I do have a word from our sponsor. LD Player is a pretty sweet emulator. Like, to be honest, I am migrating a whole bunch of my games over to LD Player. For me personally, it's the performance. Like, the performance of some of the other emulators, it's been kind of lacking in the recent years. And as you can see, especially for this game, it's just like silky smooth, right? And like, I use this also, as you can see, for PGR. So you can see that up here. It's got all of your usual settings like root. It's got like keyboard mapping. It's got like, you know, the sounds, the multi-instance. However, especially with like the most recent update, like a 4.0.62, I believe the memory usage optimizations have been improved. And so if you guys do want to check out LD Player, I have a link down in the comments and description below. And so that being said, let's get back to the video. But yeah, all in all, I think you guys can see why this is quite similar to Precon for you Precon players, because I know that's probably the majority of you. But yeah, let me talk about the end game loop, because in Precon or in like some of the other games, we have stuff like clan battles or like PvP arena, stuff like that, right? And so from what I can tell, the end game loop of this is like, we clear out the story and then you farm out like the hard quest as well as the normal quest. So right now we have chapter 6 and chapter 7. And so we also have the hard mode for the same things. And then with all of that stuff, you upgrade your characters, you upgrade your equipments, you build equipment, stuff like that. All for the purpose, like from what I can tell, to do battle arena. So if I come in over here again, like this is just a quick reminder that we are going to be killing the bosses. And so on the screen, what you're going to notice is I have a silver 2 over here. And so I think this is my ranking. And so if I click into this boy over here, you'll be able to see like there are a whole bunch of rankings. And so essentially that's pretty much the end game, I think. It's to really compete in the battle arena to get those high scores. And it's kind of like a PvP, PvP in a ladder board sense, right? Quite common in games, but like honestly, you really could ignore it, I guess. Because otherwise, like what I really want to say about this game is that if you are looking for a main game, this isn't really it. I think out of all of the side games that I've tried so far, like this is probably the most side game that I could possibly imagine. And the reason is because I could potentially log in and do probably everything in about 5 minutes. Like the skip ticket function is so fast. Like realistically, I have 94 stamina up here. I can come over here into quests. I can slam this guy over here. I can like click one of these guys and I can like click him, and then I could like skip ticket like 8 times, right? Or 9 times to sync everything. And from my perspective, I love that because like I like playing side games. I like incremental progression like over a long period of time. However, what I will say to like you more competitive people is that there might be a little bit like that's kind of, left to be desired. After you hit end game, so I'm talking like quest, and then like when you go into the main quest and then you've actually finished all of these chapters over here, it kind of feels empty, right? Because like if I hop over here, like this is an event, right? So battle boss. And so as you can see over here, the event really is surrounding like this boss battle, which is pretty much like your normal quest, right? The only thing that's different about this boss battle is that you consume tickets instead of stamina and you can actually like roll like some items for it. But aside from that, the gameplay itself is actually identical. So like, yeah, this is realistically, it really is a side game. Actually, I think like instead of calling it a side game, it's probably better described as more of like a visual novel. And what I mean by that is like, just like Precon, there are an insane amount of stories going on. So if I click into here, you're going to be able to see like there is actually quite a lot going on, right? Like, yeah. Oh yeah. And so if you guys are Konosuba fans, like this is probably right up your alley. And so like, I don't want to spoil anything, so I'm not going to click into it. But yeah, I would say that this is probably where it's very similar to Precon. It's pretty much like half game, half stories, or like half animations. Generally speaking, it's a very, very casual game, and that's right up my alley. And like, honestly, like all of these like little incremental progressions, all of these cute waifus, like on it, this is right up my alley. The fact that it actually does not take up like overly much time, like I freaking love it, right? I got so many other freaking games I'm got going on. Aside from that, like all of the other features are quite familiar. So if I click into this jobs icon over here, so essentially you're sending your characters out to like actually go farm some potions, farm some money, stuff like that, right? We get materials over here. That's actually quite a lot of materials. What the frick? How long have they been gone? Anyway, yeah, but that's yeah, it's very similar like systems to other games. It's not really really overly much. I think for me, the best way to describe it is that it's nothing really new. It's that they just do everything that the other games do, but better. But yeah, it's just like so incredibly responsive. Like the devs at this point are like very, very generous. I don't know if it's gonna like keep going on. And the gameplay itself, like it's very casual and it's very lighthearted. Like if you guys have watched Konosuba, then like, you know, have at it. You guys already know what this is gonna be like. But yeah, overall, like first impressions of this game, like I'm pretty impressed. I had this on my radar. I knew this was coming. I was actually a part of the soft launch. Like I'm in Australia, right? So this was available to me like 30 days ago, but I wasn't going to pick it up. And I'm still not sure if I am going to pick it up because I'm just like overwhelmed with games right now. However, I'm kind of like in the end game loop already where I can just dump my skip tickets. And like, if it's going to continue being like that, I might be able to hold on to this one. Because to be honest, like, even though I'm not a massive fan of Konosuba, I really like this game. It's got like really insane production value. I'm pretty sure like everything is voiced. I know you guys can't hear it, but like, I just don't want to get DMCA'd. The game actually feels smooth. It feels good to play, unlike some other games that are operating in 30 FPS. Like, and yeah, hopefully that was like a pretty good summary in terms of like what this is all about. And so hopefully you guys enjoyed that, or you guys can like understand like how this all goes. But yeah, that was a pretty good summary of like the entire game. So hopefully you guys found that kind of useful and like mildly entertaining. Yeah, if I had the time, I would continue playing this. And like right now I'm scrambling for time. Like I'm kind of like looking at what I could potentially drop for this. And so I guess with that being said, I think we've covered everything. And so let's start wrapping this video up. I've got a secret question for you guys, and that is, will you guys be picking this game up? Have you guys tried it already? I've got a whole bunch of comments on other videos that are like, oh, are you playing Konosuba? And so if you guys are playing it, or if you don't want to play it, like let me know down in the comments below, and I would really appreciate it because it actually means that you've watched up until the end of the video. And so thank you guys so much. But otherwise, please consider a like, a follow, a sub, a comment. You guys already know what it is. But please do keep in mind that I don't know if I'm going to like continue making KonoFan videos. And so for now, please don't expect that from me. But as Leah once said, all good things must come to an end. And so thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll catch you guys in the next video. Bye-bye.